Penguin Audio presents The Tao of Willie, A Guide to the Happiness in Your Heart by Willie Nelson with Turk Pipkin. Read by Willie Nelson, Turk Pipkin, and Tom Stechschulte.
Hi, I'm Turk Pipkin. This is The Tao of Willie, a book I wrote with my friend, Willie Nelson. The Time of the Teacher, an Introduction. Some things never change. Just like when we were kids playing games on a warm summer evening, the world is still comprised of two basic types of people, hiders and seekers. Hiders are generally happy right where they are, while seekers are more likely to look for something new. In our heart, most of us know which one we are. There's also a third type of person, the master, one who teaches, inspires, and shows the way for the rest of us. In a game of hide-and-seek, a master will never be found, unless they want to be. Those of us on the student side of life, hiders and seekers alike, need teachers to smooth life's bumpy path or to help us laugh at ourselves when we veer off course and land on our asses. If you're thinking that doesn't apply to you because you haven't landed on your ass lately, just wait. You will. My name is Turk Pipkin, and I'd known Willie Nelson 20 years before I realized how much I'd learned from him, 2 decades before I realized that without his even trying, he'd been showing me the way all along. For me, Willie Nelson has been that rarest of people, a teacher. There was a time, of course, when Willie was a student like the rest of us. But I think that somewhere along the way, he found himself on a higher path, so to speak. The Tao of Willie is a stroll along that path with a Texas boy who was born with an old soul and whose heart seems to grow younger with each passing year. Now, before you go thinking I'm gay for the guy, let's get one thing straight. I'm not setting Willie up to be some kind of prophet, to have infallible judgment, or to be sneaking up on perfection. After all, I've seen his golf swing. I've also seen firsthand as Willie weathered his own share of bumps and falls, and one of the greatest lessons I've learned from him is the value of picking yourself up, dusting off your butt, and getting back on the road again. Perhaps the best I can say of Willie Hugh Nelson is that no one I know has laughed harder or loved life more. And if you really want to learn something, what could be better than how to laugh and love? According to the ancient Chinese philosophy of the Tao Te Ching, it is possible to look into one man's eyes and see the entire universe. As a longtime friend and Willie's co-author of this little book of thoughts and wisdom, I've had the opportunity to look into Willie's eyes and into the thoughts that give those eyes their shine. Many of Willie's thoughts are more Baptist than Buddhist, some more cowboy than Indian, but all have stood the test of time through Willie's achievement as a family man, as a friend to everyone he meets, as a believer in justice and freedom, and as one of the great legends of American music. It would and will take an entire book of wit and wisdom to give a fair account of what Willie the student has learned, but first I offer my own brief accounting of a few things that I've learned from him. Call it my Ode to Willie. Who knows, maybe I am gay for the guy. Willie Nelson is an American icon. His voice as comforting as the American landscape, his songs as familiar as the color of the sky, his face as worn as the Rocky Mountains. Perhaps that's why it's been suggested we add his face to the cliffs of Mount Rushmore and be done with it. For half a century, he's played countless concerts across America and around the world. His appeal crosses nearly all social and economic lines, and he's been instrumental in shaping both country and pop music. He's called an outlaw, though from Farm Aid to the aftermath of September 11, from the resurrection of a burned-out courthouse in his hometown to fanning the flame of the Olympics, it is Willie Nelson who brings us together. If America could sing with one voice, said Emmylou Harris, it would be Willie's. Willie Nelson is a highwayman. He may have traded his horse for a tour bus, but he still rides into your town, kidnaps your girl's heart, and pockets just enough of your cash to keep his life in order. And you can hardly wait for him to come back and do it all again next year. It helps if people love you. Another lesson from the master. Willie Nelson is a joker. After years on the road, he knows thousands of jokes and can, at any given time, remember 3. All three, by the way, will make you laugh. Come back next Wednesday, and he'll give you three more. Here's the last one he tossed out at me. A skeleton walks into a bar and says, "Give me a beer and a mop." If you don't get it, read it again. It must be funny. I'm still telling it. Laugh, and don't give a damn whether the world laughs with you. Willie Nelson has music in his heart. On the radio or in concert, Willie can reach out and touch you. He can set a life back on track with the sound of his voice or the proceeds of his fame. Can soothe the madness in your brain with a plaintive gypsy chord progression, or spark love like a wildfire from a single burning ember. He's cut 250 albums, written 2,500 songs, and sold 39 million records. As we say in Texas, that ain't mice nuts. Willie Nelson has changed the lives of thousands of people, including my own. More importantly, Willie Nelson also changed his life, and I do mean for the better. After beating his hard head against the music business in Nashville during the 50s and 60s, Willie was on hard times. He'd long ago sold some of his best songs, like Nightlife and Family Bible, for a few tens in folding money. His house in Nashville had burned down, and he was sick and tired of trying to be something that he was not. Making the wisest decision of his life, Willie decided that he cared more about his family, friends, and simply making music than he did about trying to be a star. Moving home to Texas, he wrapped himself in a cocoon of indifference to other people's opinions and eventually unfolded his new wings and soared. Willie puts it a little more simply. "When I started counting my blessings," he says, "my whole life turned around." Before long, Willie had helped to heal one of America's greatest divides by inspiring hippies and rednecks to realize they weren't all that different from each other. The next thing we knew, the rednecks had grown their hair out, the hippies were wearing boots, and you couldn't tell them apart anymore. He may yet do the same thing for Democrats and Republicans, though I don't advise that you hold your breath on that one. Like the Chinese masters of the Tao Te Ching, Willie learned that when you put your life in a good place, good things follow. If you spend enough time around Willie and watch how easy he is in the company of everyone from billionaires to bums, you sometimes suspect that he's some kind of chameleon. But the truth is, Willie's the same person no matter who he's with. He can talk to a congressional leader about farm policy, and an hour later he'll be jamming with a punk rock band. By being true to what is unique about himself, he connects each of us to the best part of ourselves. No less amazing is his ability to shine in many different situations. Having played as many as 54 holes of golf with him on a single day, I've long wondered how a guy whose swing looks like he's flycasting a frozen turkey can so often walk away the winner. "If you care too much," Willie once told me on the golf course, "you'll screw up every time." Whether he was talking about golf or life, I'm not exactly sure. Willie Nelson is a gambler. Willie has also learned how to sit opposite you on a chessboard with a smile on his face and cut you to ribbons, using surprise openings, sneak attacks, and subtle psychology to goad you into a sense of overconfidence that will be over all too soon. The hallmark of a game of chess with Willie is that, whether in the opening, middle, or end game, you'll think you're doing just fine right up to the point that you realize you're screwed. Watch out for the red-headed stranger. Sum it up, and you've got a wise guy, musical poet, who is both yin and yang, heads and tails, Indian and cowboy, a hero to city slickers and country bumpkins, a prophet, a preacher, a poet, and despite the lyrics to Kris Kristofferson's song, not a problem when he's stoned. The subtle yet simple lessons of the Tao Te Ching are a nice match for the simple philosophy that seems to keep Willie on course in his life. A philosophy that can help all of us find happiness through simply being. "We're going to keep doing it wrong," says Willie, "until we like it that way." Is he joking? Sure, but in that joke, Willie demonstrates a good grasp of the Tao. He's going to do things his way, even if you think his way is a little weird. Who knows? You may be a Taoist yourself and not even know it. If you put your boots on before you put your pants on, because you like it that way, then you're at one with the Tao. Or you have small feet and a great big butt. There is no single definition of the Tao, but I like to think of it as finding a balance between resistance and surrender. If you try to walk against the current in a flowing stream, for instance, Your journey will be a constant struggle. If you lose your footing and are carried away by the current, no matter how you struggle, you may drown. But if you float with the current, you will become a part of the river and will be carried on an incredible ride. In the same way, if you let yourself join the river of life, you will be carried on an amazing journey. The river starts here, and Willie Nelson is our guide. Shall we wade into the water?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.